All right, in our last session, we left you with the install files for UPK in your UPK folder on your C drive. So we need to open those up. Go to this folder, go to this folder, come down to the setup executable file. You want to double click that to open that file. Say yes. And depending on the language you want to use, make your selection. You can choose to read the installation guide if you wish. There are some very good tips there. Familiar enough with loading programs on your PC, then this probably isn't necessary. You can just forge ahead. Choose your language. This is probably one of the most critical steps at this point. You want to pull down this list and you want to make sure, absolutely sure, that you use the single user license. I'm assuming you're doing this on your own PC, either at a work environment or at home, and you want a single user install. Client and server, or for installations where you would work in a client server environment with multiple users. In this case, we just want a single user. Accept the defaults here. Go ahead and click Next. Begin the install process. This part takes a little time. I'll try to do some creative editing and shorten this for you. A good warning to point out. I have seen this take some time. I've never seen it take over an hour though. Once it's finished installing, click the Finish button.